Fire Nation crew and founder of something we call the We On Fire Cypher. Now, a lot of times when it comes to creatives, cyphers are a thing that happen between music artists or, in our case, dancers. I found early on in life that there wasn't a lot of dancers to come across, so I decided to create an avenue for dancers to connect, network, and to be able to find a free space and also a safe space to pretty much express their art. There wasn't a lot of places that I found while I was coming up as a dancer that actually made me feel safe or made me feel as though I could actually progress without criticism or without being pulled down by someone that was jealous. So we create the We On Fire Cypher for creatives of all different avenues. So when you come to this cypher, you don't have to be a dancer. Some people, we actually just like people to come that just enjoy the culture of dance in general. So we have artists, we have photographers, videographers, all different types of people in different forms of art that come around and network. Now eventually, yes, we'll have vendors. Right now, we like to travel in different areas, first it was different cities, then it became different states, and now we're in different countries. Last September, we had a cypher in Uganda, and so far we are working on things in other places in Africa as well, but that turnout was amazing. It was an eye-opener for me, because at that point, I saw the fruits of my labor. I saw what was coming to be of the dream that I had a few years ago, thinking that nothing could happen from that. I was just gonna have a few dancers come around. But that right there should be proof in itself that with the mind of two people, one, and networking and resources, you can make almost anything happen. Community is key to almost everything you do. With that being said, I'm gonna give my hand over to my right hand.
So I agree, of course. For those of you who do know me, I again. For those who don't, my name is Firefly. I am co-founder of Fire Nation Crew. We established this crew in 2020, but before we get into that, I do want to point out two people. The first one is Flo. Now, I had met Flo back in 2018. I was part of a performance for a ceremony called Day in the Life, where they were giving honor to two ladies that were pretty much pillars of the community, and they were in the arts, and they were doing a lot to help bring positivity to the community. They were mentors and friends of mine. And I remember when I met him then, it was like, yeah, you know, he wasn't like all the other artists. And it was that connection that dropped the seed, because then after that, he ended up hitting me up in 2020 to do a visual on a bridge. And I was like, you know what? That's cool. I didn't know who this man was when I first met him, or even the second time I met him, because he's literally been the most genuine person, right? But after that, it was like the light bulb went off. I ended up following both of his pages, because I followed the Global Flow one, but I didn't follow the Sick Flow one yet until he made that song. I found Mr. 47, I-47, I found you because of that. You and I had been in a music video already before that, so all of us ended up having common pieces of the same puzzle. Now, the idea for our crew, the whole concept of being like Fire Nation, was to create a collective of dancers and people who wanted to do something in the community that were on fire and had passion for their artistry. And that is what became the hub of what we do. That's where We On Fire comes from. And I know, as modest as she is, Kuma's biggest thing is she doesn't ever just do something for herself. So we've already started the crew by this point. We're starting to do our thing. We had people tell us some things that we found were kind of interesting. Like, they told us you would never ever be able to make it doing a family-friendly event in Atlanta. Nobody wants that. Nobody wants to hear about the old school when it comes to hip-hop or what the original virtues and values were. They also told us that what we were doing was a failing art. These are things that I laugh at now, honestly, because within a year, we went from being just a crew that people kind of heard about to being known internationally. Not because we were out there yelling that we're the loudest or the greatest, but because we were genuinely creating movement in the community. We're building events, we were building all kinds of networks with people, reaching out to people who also had a desire to do what they do. I took what I was doing individually with my Battle of Business Mentality classes, teaching artists and creatives the basic pathways they need to navigate around these individuals that take the life out of other people by absorbing them under their banners, what we call eclipsing, taking somebody else's artistry and putting their logo on top of it like it's theirs. We also started reaching out and building events to bring back the original values, virtues, and elements of original hip-hop. and telling people that it's not an old thing, it's not a distant thing, it is a now thing, it is a thing that was built back in August 11th, 1973 to beat the odds that people were given, right? That was the entire point, was to take what they had, build a patchwork puzzle piece, put something together with that, put it out there and say, hey, this is how we're gonna save our own lives. Since the community that exists doesn't wanna recognize us, we build our own. That's why we have nicknames, that's why we have crew names, that's why we have our own appearance in hip hop as a cultural movement. Arts have always been our way of giving ourselves identity and collective representation. All of that became part of our hub, and as people kept telling us we couldn't do it, we kept saying, bet. And then doing it. And it went from talking about us to copying our words, because now they were inspired. They went from saying we couldn't do it to asking us how did we do it, because they finally realized it was possible. And sometimes people like to build their paths on what they think are stones, stepping stones, but those are really the skulls of other people whose dreams you've stepped on and destroyed because you didn't think it was possible. And we're about bringing that and breaking that particular element away. We believe in the Most High. And with what he gives us and what he shows us, we're allowed to move forward on that, just like everybody is allowed to move forward on that. I had a conversation with Flo about this. I've had conversations with Mr. Wayne about this. And me and Mr. 547, I see you up there, I see you, was talking about this before too. So for her, when she had that dream to do this and she told me about it, we were just sitting on the stage after practicing together. We didn't know a year later that we would be connected with people that are international. We didn't know a year later 200 plus people from multiple countries in Africa would converge in Uganda under the guise of feeling and understanding and wanting to perpetuate everything we teach here and create a movement based on this. We didn't know we were going to have members in Germany, members in Africa, members in the Philippines that are now representing and doing this in their communities too. But it's not just about us. With what Mr. Duane is doing with flowers, we understand that things happen in life. People throw dirt on you. Well, you're a seed, you're a flower. So when they throw dirt on you, guess what? Add a little water and you'll keep growing. And pretty much when you get to the top and that blossom comes up, they'll call it, oh, you're being arrogant, you're hating, you know, you're trying to be seen. No. The truth is your flower was literally fertilized in the most fertile soil possible because you were told to overcome two things. The I can't and the I can. Because once you realize you can say, I can, and they can say, I can't, all they want, if you don't listen to them, that flower is going to keep growing. And before you know it, you've got an entire flower patch. You're not giving flowers out to the dead, you're handing bouquets to the living. That's what we stand for. So, and I don't want to be long-winded because I know we got things we got to take care of, but I want to say thank you again for allowing us to even talk about this. And just for those who follow us, those who are keeping up with our journey, thank you. You know, and for those of you who might not think you've started your journey, progress is progress, whether it's big or small. That's a matter of perception, not a matter of reality. Y'all have